long way, but we finally made it. Thank you so much for coming. And it's such an honor for me to have you and Eric and Lizzie and Caroline, Lizzie here, and I thank you. And you all, Sie alle, von allen, die sehr glücklich sein, denn eigentlich wurde alles schon gesagt und wir haben gar nicht mehr viel übrig. Und ich danke Ihnen ganz herzlich, Generalkonsul Johnson. It was just really great, and it was so American, and it was so lively. Thank you so much for coming, and happy Thanksgiving.
Eigentlich alles schon einfach gesagt, aber trotzdem, wir sind in den letzten Tagen immer wieder gefragt worden, warum Lillian Bestmann und warum Paul Hemmel in Hamburg. Und ich kann das ganz kurz mit drei Aspekten begründen. Erstens gehören Lillian Bestmann und Paul Hemmel, es wurde schon mehrfach gesagt, unter den Meistern der Fotografie des 20. Jahrhunderts zu den großen kreativen Persönlichkeiten, die aus verschiedenen Gründen einem breiten Publikum noch nicht bekannt sind. Und zweitens hat das Haus der Fotografie, Herr Lobo hat darauf hingewiesen, sich zur Aufgabe gemacht, herausragende fotografische Positionen wiederzuentdecken und zu thematisieren. Und drittens zeigen wir mit dieser weltweit ersten umfassenden Retrospektive dieses amerikanischen Künstlerehepaares, das 77 Jahre lang zusammen gelebt hat, ein fotografisches Oeuvre, das bis heute an Modernität eingebüßt hat und gerade für eine jüngere Generation, die im Zeitalter digitaler Technik aufwächst, auch von besonderem Interesse sein kann. Aber ich muss uns erwähnen, dass es dennoch wenige glückliche, fast zufällige Begebenheiten waren, die heute zu diesem Ereignis
geführt haben. Steps that was necessary to reach today, and now she...
Anfang der 80er Jahre stand ich in einer kleinen Galerie außerhalb von New York, und in den Hinterzimmerchen der Galerie hatte die Galeristin ihre Chefs. Darunter war ein Bild, das sehr lange
davor.
Plötzlich sagte eine Stimme hinter mir, it's called to die. And the photographer Lillian Bestmann. This was the first time that I ever heard the name Lillian Bestmann. Next to it was another picture. It had nothing to do with the diver, but it was like the same kind of work. I was absolutely fascinated. I used to work as a fashion editor for many years, and this was really the first time I came over a piece of art that I had never seen before. And so, time went by, and then I went to Paris for the collection and met a friend on the stage. I used to work at 17 Magazine, and she was with a colleague. She introduced me to the colleague, it was Carolyn Miller, and we went to the opening, and it was a very big opening because the pyramid was like the big thing, and there were huge black and white prints, and I was just standing there and saying, oh my goodness, this is Lillian Bestmann. She's my most favorite photographer. And Carolyn Miller turned around and she said, and she's my mother-in-law. And this was really the key point. And I said, oh my goodness, could I call her? Sure, I give you her telephone number. And this is how it started. I called Lillian, she invited me to come, and I had a wonderful time. She opened her heart, and she opened all the boxes, and showed me her photography. And so we spent quite a long time together over the years, and one day I said, Lillian, we need to do an exhibition. And then she said, do you know Paul's work? I said, no. And she gave me a big book. And I was standing there, sitting there, and I went for a long time through the book. And I was so touched because somehow I found the missing part of two wonderful people. And then I said, we have to do this exhibition with both of you. And she said, okay, let's ask Paul. So the next day I met Paul Hemmel, and it was really like love at first sight, Lillian knows it. and he always has a twinkle in the eye when he was talking to me.